I am Aditya Patnaik. My science experiment was a question which was, can we artificially weaken or change the direction of a hurricane? My purpose was that many people die and hundreds of billions of dollars are lost because of hurricanes. For example, this last season, there were three hurricanes that cost us over $60 billion, and it was the costliest hurricane, Atlantic hurricane season on record. My purpose is to find if strong hurricanes that may happen in the future can be diverted using any technique possible. My question is it possible to artificially weaken or change the direction of a hurricane? So my research was, over the recent years, hurricanes have been increasing in strength due to global warming, which is increasing water temperatures. A hurricane thrives and becomes stronger in energy if the sea surface temperature is greater than 80 degrees Fahrenheit. If the sea surface temperature is less than 80 degrees Fahrenheit, the hurricane changes its direction or weakens. If a hurricane happens to go over land or mountains, the hurricane will rapidly weaken. In a hurricane, the lower the air pressure, the stronger the hurricane. My hypothesis is, if we make the water surface cooler in the wake of an incoming hurricane, we can alter the path or weaken the hurricane, which may turn the strongest of hurricanes, like Katrina, weak, harmless, and fizzle out without causing any damage. To represent a hurricane, we used a fog machine and looked at the fog to see the path of the hurricane. So the devices I used were a drill, a plastic tube, a glue gun, a knife, a smoke machine, smoke fluid, a candle, ice pack, styrofoam, and wood blocks. Since I can't make a hurricane in real life, I made a plan to see if air will go to the colder side or warmer side. Fog went from the fog machine through a vertical plastic tube to the horizontal plastic tube. Both sides of the horizontal plastic tube were open. One side of the horizontal tube was made cold by an ice pack, and one side was hot by a candle. We considered four different scenarios for two sides. The first one was both at room temperature. The second one was at one at room temperature, one side at hot. The third one was one side at room temperature, one side at cold. And the fourth scenario was one side was hot and one side was cold. So my first experiment was both sides are in room temperature. So the result was smoke gets distributed equally to both sides. My second experiment was that one side is hot and one side is at room temperature. And the result was that the smoke went to the side that is hot. My third experiment was that one side is cold and the other side is at room temperature. And the smoke went to the side at room temperature. For my fourth scenario, one side is hot and the other side is cold, and the result was that the fog goes toward the hotter side. This is a chart that shows experiment one, condition left side is at room temperature, condition right side at room temperature, and the smoke gets distributed evenly, and then so on, like I showed in the previous slide. And my observations and analysis of data was that I found that the smoke always went to the hotter side of the plastic tube. Because of pressured smoke from the fog machine, smoke always went to both sides, but later on, it always went to the warmer side. Air tends to go to the low pressure, so the smoke went to the hotter side. This happened because on the hot side, there was low air pressure, but on the cold side, there was high air pressure. My conclusion is that air goes to the lower pressure or the warmer side. So if one side is made cooler, air can be diverted to go toward the hotter side. My first idea for this was, if we make the sea surface temperature colder than 80 degrees Fahrenheit, we may change the direction or weaken a hurricane. One way to do that is to put ice everywhere in the path of the hurricane. There is a restriction to this, which is that the price of the ice may be equal or be greater than the actual cost of the hurricane. Another idea is to create wind shear by blowing lots of air on one area of the hurricane, so that it will weaken in unbalanced conditions. This too has a restriction that you will need a lot of fast air, which may be hard to achieve. One last idea is that the hurricane hunters can go onto the hurricane because they have the capability to and drop bags of cold water, which will lead to the water temperature decreasing. And so the hurricane will most likely weaken. Again, the price for cold water may equal out with what the hurricane's actual cost would have been. Also, if the water temperature may not decrease in the water, and that would be a disaster. Real experiments are challenging, and we can confirm this idea only if it works after multiple large-scale demonstrations of real hurricanes. Thank you.